Hi everyone, this is Edward, and this is the WPT in Action. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
We want to say Happy Yom Kippur to everyone. This is a video to remind everyone that Yom Kippur is one of the highest holy day in the Bible. It's scriptural. A lot of people nowadays are saying the Jewish feast, but actually it's not a Jewish feast. It is a biblical feast. It's a feast that Yahweh have placed for us to observe. We're going to be reading in the book, in the Bible, where it says that we must celebrate this holiday. Angela.
And Elohim spoke unto Moses, saying, also on the 10th day of this 7th month there shall be an holy convocation unto you, and you shall afflict your souls and offer an offering made by fire unto Elohim. And ye shall do no work in the same day, for it is a day of anointment, to make an atonement for you before for Elohim your Yah. For whosoever soul it be that shall not be afflicted in that same day, he shall be cut off from among his people. And whosoever soul it be that don't any work in that same day, the same soul will I destroy from among his people. Ye shall do no manner for work. It shall be a statute forever throughout your generations in all your dwellings. It shall be unto you a Sabbath of rest, and ye shall afflict souls, your souls, in the ninth day of the month as evening, even from even unto even, shall ye celebrate your Sabbath.
Amen. Amen. And that was read from what book, Angelo?
Leviticus.
Chapter?
Chapter 23.
Verse what?
26 to 32.
Amen. It's in the book of Leviticus. Yahweh asks us that it's a convocation that we all come together, but most of all, it's an atonement. It's a day that we must come before Yah in repentance of our sins, that our names may be sealed in the Lamb's Book of Life. Okay, Yom Kippur is not just a holiday, but it's one of the highest holy day. And the scriptural. As believers of Yahushua, the Messiah, we no longer have to follow tradition, whereas the high priest would go into the tabernacle, would go into the Holy of Holies and make atonement for our sins. As Yahushua believers, when we have accepted Yahushua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, as our Elohim Adonai and Savior, the Messiah of the world, he becomes, his blood that was shed for us, becomes our atonement for our sin. What does that mean? That means in Yahushua, we repent. And the blood that was shed for us on the cross, on Calvary, is the blood that washes away our sin. That was the atonement of our sin, meaning that we no longer have to depend on a human high priest to go in or make sacrifices for the atonement of our sin. All we need to do is come before the presence of Elohim Adonai and repent of our sin, affliction of our soul, search deep and within us of the sins that we have done, and ask forgiveness, believing that Yeshua's blood, that was the atonement of our sin, is going to wash it away and make us white as snow. Now, as a believer in Yahushua, we don't just do this once a year. So why do we Christians that are non-Jews have to celebrate the Holy Feast, have to celebrate Yom Kippur? Because it's a reminder. It's a reminder that Yahushua HaMashiach, now as the Messiah, and the sacrifice that he did, he was the sacrificial lamb who took away the sins of the world. He is the atonement of our sins right now. So we reflect on that, because every feast is we must come before his throne in repentance. Before we pray, we should always afflict our souls to see our sins and ask forgiveness. It's not an excuse for us to keep going and sinning, but on days like Yom Kippur, this is where we pour out our heart. This is where we really seek our temple. We really clean our temple and know that the blood of Yahushua is the atonement of our sin. Okay, it's a solemn day of prayer. It's called the Sabbath of the Sabbath. It's a day of rest. It's the day that one should not work or not go to school. One should not be cooking or cleaning. It's a day, and it's not just a day of rest, but it's a day that we must be praying. We pray that our names are sealed in the Lamb Book of Life. We pray that, first of all, we pray that our names are in the Lamb's Book of Life. How do we know that? By accepting Yeshua HaMashiach as Elohim Adonai, a Savior. And Emilio, how do one have their names written in the Lamb Book of Life? What must one do to get your names written in the Lamb Book of Life?
And be baptized.
And, but first, and what's the first thing?
The salvation prayer.
The salvation prayer, meaning that we accept who? As our Lord and Savior, as Elohim Adonai Messiah, and we must believe. And the next step that we do is what? You said it, Elijah.
Baptism.
It's the baptism. The baptism, what it does, it
you being reborn
and the Spirit. So the Holy Spirit, the precious Ruach HaKodesh, dwell in us, is among you, is at this moment allowing you to be into a level, not in the flesh, but in the Spirit, in the Ruach of Yahweh. Also, that is one of the key elements that is needed for your names to be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Yom Kippur is a reminder also that it must be sealed, meaning that it can be erased, it can be taken out of the book. So with Yom Kippur, if you have never ever repented of your sin or kept away from a certain sin, because a lot of time we repent of a sin but we keep doing it and doing it and doing it, you're trampling on the shed blood of Yahushua, you're making a mockery of it, okay? And your name can very well be taken off, be blotted out in the Lamb's Book of Life. So we have to make sure, on this day of Yom Kippur, it's a day of reflection, it's a day of affliction of the souls. It's a day that we really should think, we bow our heads. And one of the Psalms in the Bible that I like very much is the Psalm of David, which is Psalm 51. And I'd like, Emilio, if you're gonna read it, who's going to read it? Was it you?
Psalm
59. 51. No, I believe you are 51. Yeah, you were 46. Yes. And we'll bow our heads as Elijah, you will read it. Okay.
To the chief musician, a psalm of David, when Nathan the prophet came to him after he had gone into Beersheba. Have mercy on me, O Yahweh, according thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my
transgressions.
Wash me through for my iniquities, and cleanse me from my sin. I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned and done this evil in thy sight, that thou mightest be justified when thou speakest and be clear with thy judges.
Yes.
Behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Behold, through Desiree's truth.
Read a little louder.
Truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part through shout, make me to know wisdom. Purge me with ice.
Purge me with hyssop.
Hyssop. And I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me to hear joy and gladness, that the bones which thou hast broken my rejoice. Hide thy face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart.
Oh Yahweh,
and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Then will I teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be converted unto thee. Deliver me from the guiltiness, O Yahweh, the Yahweh of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing aloud of thy righteousness, O Lord. O Elohim, open thy my lips, and my mouth shall sue for thy praise. For thou desirest and not sacrifice, else would I give it. Thou delightest not in burnt offering. The sacrifices of Yahweh are broken spirit, a broken and big
and strife.
And try heart, O Yahweh, thou wilt not despise. Do good in thy good pleasure unto Zion.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay.
Amen.
I wanna point out some stuff here. In Psalm 51. Psalm 51, verse 7, where it says, "Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow." Now we say, "Purge me with the shed blood of Yahushua HaMashiach, and I shall be cleansed. And wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me to hear joy and gladness, that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice. Hide thy face from my sins, and blot out all of mine iniquities." Create, we repeat this, WPT in action. Repeat after me. Create in me.
Create in me
a clean heart.
A clean heart.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
And renew a right spirit.
And renew a right spirit
within me.
Within me.
Cast me not away.
Cast me not away
from thy presence.
From thy presence.
And take not.
And take not
thy Ruach HaKodesh.
Thy Ruach HaKodesh
from me.
From me.
Restore unto me.
Restore unto me
the joy of thy salvation.
The joy of thy salvation.
And uphold me.
And uphold me
with the free.
With the free
Ruach.
Ruach.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay. See, one of the things that happens when we're in sin and we not repent is that the Ruach, the Spirit of Yahweh, is removed from us. The Holy Spirit, the sweet Ruach HaKodesh, our precious Mama Shekinah glory, is removed from us. Okay? So, on this Yom Kippur, we have to afflict our souls. See, David was afflicting his soul. He had done something he shouldn't have done, and he knew that he was in sin. And he actually, when I learned this prayer a while back, and this part where it says, "For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me." The pastor who was saying that, he would pound against his chest with his fist. You guys, hold your fist. And he says, "Against thee. Against thee,
against thee,
against thee,
against thee, against thee,
against thee, have I sinned, and done this evil in thy sight." And the reason why, he pounded against his chest, because it was a sign of saying to his soul, "I have sinned against you, Abba Yahweh. I have sinned against you, Abba Yahweh. I have sinned against you." And it was a affliction of our soul. It was an act of surrendering, an act of pleading, a plague of saying forgiveness. And then back in David's time, there wasn't yet an atonement for the sin, except they had to make animal sacrifice. So they, he and they was using things like hyssop, which is a sort of a plant that's like soapy. But now we have the shed blood of Yahushua HaMashiach. We have the blood of the Lamb who is the atonement of the sin of the world, of our sin, that we must use that to ask forgiveness and ask the Ruach HaKodesh to help us to keep holy and righteous as Yahweh is holy and righteous. In this moment, we're going to take a time as we reflect our soul, as we reflect our body, our temple, of the sins that we have done, the sins that we've done knowingly and unknowingly. To those of you who wants to join us this moment, bow our heads as we listen to Kol Nadril. In the name of Yahushua HaMashiach. Us this day of Yom Kippur and look and search into our hearts, precious Mama Shekinah glory, and bring to surface sins that we have not asked forgiveness for, sins, hidden sins, sins that we believe by not saying it, it stays hidden, but Abba Yahweh, you are the Creator, you are our Father, you are the Master, you are our Maker. What our sins are, you know what we have done, you know what's hidden deep inside our soul. By the power of the Ruach HaKodesh and the name of Yeshua Mashiach, bring it to surface so we may repent. Father, in this end times that we're living at, we stand in the gap as warrior prayer team in action, as intercessors. And we ask for repentance of all of those, Father, who are out there that don't know you, that don't know you yet. We ask that they make, that the Holy Spirit, that the Ruach HaKodesh go and minister to their hearts. Give them a discernment. Give them a feeling of repentance on this day of Yom Kippur. For in the flesh we can't do it, but by the power of Imayah, by the power of the precious Ruach HaKodesh, the mighty wind can go throughout the four corners of the world, to every corner, to every inches and length and byways and hallways, and reach the lost souls, so that they may repent of their sin, accept Yahushua HaMashiach as Elohim Adonai, so that their names not only may be written in the Lamb Book of Life, but on this day of Yom Kippur, that their names may also be sealed. Father, I pray that my name is sealed in this day of Yom Kippur. Forgive me, Father, for my sins. Forgive me for the sins that I've done knowingly and unknowingly. I plead the blood of Yahushua HaMashiach over my temple, over my home, over my children, over my loved ones. And that they may come forth before your throne, Father, in this day of Yom Kippur, and repent. There are so many things going on in this world, Father. I pray that the Ruach HaKodesh abide, go forth, and bring forth repentance to the heart of the people, so that they may repent of their sins. Father, I lift up every member, every brother and sister of mine in the Mighty One Ministry, everyone who's striving to be holy and striving to be righteous. Father, I pray that their names may be sealed in the Lamb Book of Life. I pray, Father, that the prayers of the righteous that avails much, Father, that you hear our prayers. Those of us that are, it's a hard time for us to keep away from our sins. Oh, Mama Shekinah, abide with us. Abide with them. Guide them. Show them the way. Speak to them. Stir into their spirit to be holy as Yahweh is holy and righteous as He's righteous. To understand that there's no sin bigger or smaller than another, and that there is an atonement for a sin on this earth. Yom Kippur. It is Yahushua HaMashiach. It is the blood of Yahushua that is the atonement of our sins. And we thank you, we praise you, we worship you. And we lift up your holy names. In the name of Yahushua HaMashiach. Amen. Amen and amen. And this is what we say. Now, one thing with Yom Kippur, I was reading, is that on a synagogue around the world, a month before Yom Kippur, they would blow the shofar, the ram's horn, after every service to wake up the people. On this YouTube video, I would like, when I first heard the shofar blown, it shook me. It shook me, and I didn't understand what it was, but there was something in my spirit that shook, woke me up from my slumber sleep. And I pray that the boys, the WPT, and actually they've been practicing, they've been blowing the shofar, so I hope they get it. I don't know who wants to go first. Okay. Hold on, let me put my thing on. Okay, you guys put yours on, because you have to put it on way before you blow your shofar. Amen. Amen. Wow, praise Yah. Again, this was just a little video that we decided to make. You guys want to say anything? Anybody want to pray or say something?
Hi, everybody. To the
four corners of the world.
Yeah, four corners of the world.
We want to say hi to Elizabeth Elijah,
Nicole
Pastor Nicomaya, Mama Catherine Yah, Papa Adams. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
All brothers and sisters. And in my UN, who else? There are special people.
The two witnesses.
The two witnesses. May Yahweh, may their names remain sealed, and may they be ready and prepared when the time come when Yahweh call them to do his important work that he has for them. We want to say happy Yom Kippur to Sister Kim, Sister Rose. Amen.
Amen.
Angelo, who else?
I forgot.
Okay, Emilio, you remember? Okay, nobody remember? Okay, anyway, yes, to all of our brothers and sisters in the Mighty One Ministry, happy Yom Kippur.
Happy Yom Kippur.
And have a blessed Sabbath of Sabbath. This is a Sabbaton. This is the biggest, it's the biggest day, biggest holy day
of the year.
And we pray that, we ask that you'll pray. I'm asking that you all keep the WPT in action in prayer. It's not easy for me to teach them, guide them, lead them. I'm doing it in the flesh, but I'm asking. I know that it's the precious Ruach HaKodesh, Mama Shekinah, Yahushua HaMashiach, and our Abba Yahweh that is the ultimate one who will lead them and who will guide them and who will show them the path. Pray that they may remain and the Ruach of Yah at all time. As they're growing, it's a battle between the world. It shouldn't be, but it is. Between the world and the kingdom of Yah. They are willing, spirit and soul. You guys love Abba Yahweh?
Yes.
You guys love, love. And who is the Ruach HaKodesh?
Holy Spirit.
And who is the, who?
Mama Shekinah.
And we call her how?
Mother.
Imaya?
Mother.
Imaya, right? Ruach HaKodesh. Mother Wisdom, Mama Shekinah Glory, okay, and our Heavenly Father is called, his name?
Yeah,
Abba
Yahweh.
Abba Yahweh, and our beloved Yahushua HaMashiach is our Elohim, Adonai, and Savior. You guys are acting so shy like you guys don't know this. Okay? You guys, so happy Yom Kippur, everyone.
Happy Yom Kippur.
And I pray that you have a blessed Sabbath and have a blessed holy day. Amen.
Amen. Bye.